What up, all you geeks, gamers, and sports fans? It's your boy Pat, aka That Varsity Geek, here with another weekend recommendation video for the weekend of July 7th through the 9th. Now, like I talked about last week, the NBA is back with a vengeance. So if you're looking for sports, check out some of the upcoming games from the NBA's restarted season. So after watching the NBA games in their restart for over a week now, I have to say that I'm really, really impressed with the quality of the product that's being put on, and I'm honestly surprised because I didn't think it was going to be as good as what I saw. The courts look really well put together and are doing a good job of getting that home team feel, whether or not it's putting the logos for the home team or putting the sponsors that they would normally have at their stadium there. And seeing as each team has four home games, it's cool to see that there's actually a difference between each team when they're playing home versus when they're supposed to be playing, you know, away. Then you also have virtual fans put up on screens that they have all over the arena, allowing fans to tune in virtually from, you know, their tablets, phones, computers, etc., and root for their teams or just root for some of their favorite players and help to get that hype factor up when you're talking about these games and how they're progressing. And you know, one of my favorite things that I found to do this week while I'm watching the NBA is during the breaks in the action when they're on timeouts or not doing anything, is to look up and see if I can see any of the fans doing anything funny or doing anything interesting like you would normally see the camera doing in an NBA game. I know one fan was eating a slice of pizza while he was being put up there virtually and he got caught on the camera. You know, that gave me a little chuckle. So it's those little things that kind of add to the elements of the game. And you know, the most important thing, the quality of the basketball. And from what I've seen this past week, that all looks really, really good. And they're doing a good job of keeping that intensity, that level of performance up that you would expect from teams fighting to be in the playoffs. Now, obviously the games have been a little bit sloppy, but we all expected that. We didn't expect them to have a super long layoff and then come back 100% ready to go, firing on all cylinders. But the energy is up. It feels like a playoff type atmosphere at all times. And so that's all we could hope for. So with the NBA being the biggest sport that is currently out right now in the US, I just wanted to highlight a couple of games that I think that you should tune into this weekend. So tonight you have two of the top teams in the East, Boston and Toronto, facing off against each other at 9 p.m. Eastern time on TNT. And then also on Saturday, you've got the Clippers facing off against Portland, who's trying to claw their way into the playoffs. That'll be also on TNT at 1 p.m. Eastern. And then you've got an interesting game between Dallas and Milwaukee coming on 8:30 p.m. Eastern time on ESPN. And so if you're looking for sports, if you didn't get enough basketball this past weekend or this past week, I know I sure haven't, definitely tune into some of these games that are going on this weekend for the NBA. And for my nerds out there, we're going to be talking about something that's a little bit nostalgic, but also brought in with a new feel in the form of Transformers or for Cybertron. Now, War for Cybertron is a new Netflix-exclusive anime that dropped last week. And honestly, looking at all this, Netflix is killing the anime game, getting a lot of exclusives. They're just doing a pretty good job of catering some of their content towards people like me who like that kind of stuff. Now, the anime itself is a 3-chapter series, with the first chapter being what released last week. And this chapter contains 6 episodes. So you're going to get pretty much 6 23 to 25 minute long episodes of Transformers War for Cybertron, until we get the next 2 chapters that'll come out sometime later. Now, War for Cybertron, as the name suggests, details the war between the Autobots and the Decepticons as they fight over their homeworld of Cybertron in an attempt to not only control Cybertron, but to gain control of the AllSpark. And the AllSpark is an item that will allow them to actually create more Transformers. So, whoever has control of the AllSpark is really in control of how Cybertron's future will go, because that's how they can create new robots. And obviously, whoever has the AllSpark is going to have an advantage in this war. Now, Transformers is probably the most popular and the most thought about series when you're talking about mecha, anime, or cartoons. It's been around for a really long time, but this is a part of Transformers' mythos and history that really hasn't been talked about a whole lot when you're talking about visual media. It's something that you kind of start after the War for Cybertron, with them being on Earth and doing other things, but none of the shows that I have seen have dealt with this part of Transformers history a lot. So it'll definitely be something new and interesting to watch and give a different spin to the Transformers world. Now, Transformers may be a classic series that has been out for a very long time, But personally, I think that it has never looked better than in War for Cybertron. The animation is helped by the technological progression that we've gone through over, you know, the past 10 to 50 years. It's allowing the Transformers to be rendered in a really cool 3D animation style that to me is the best the series has to offer. You know, the shading and the coloring of the show give it a really dark, gritty feel, similar to something like The Dark Knight was, in comparison to what you would normally think of with superhero movies. And all of that shading, all of that dark grittiness really plays well to the content that they're dealing with, because War for Cybertron is pretty much a civil war between the Autobots, who are the good guys, and the Decepticons, which are the bad guys. And so Civil War is never going to look pretty, and I think that animation style definitely plays on that and fits in perfectly. So from what I've seen, it looks dope. It's definitely an anime that you should check out if you're a fan of mecha, or if you're a fan of Transformers, or just looking for something to add to your list of things. So check that out this weekend. It's out on Netflix. And lastly, for my gamers out there, if you're looking for a new, you know, RPG to play, why don't you check out Fairy Tail the Video Game. Now, Fairy Tail the Video Game is the first US video game for the popular shonen series of the same name, and it was released last Friday on July 31st. Now, this game is an action RPG that uses turn-based combat to really try to bring players into the world of Fairy Tail, you know, allow players to experience Fairy Tail's unique and diverse world in a video game. And like I said, this is the first time that you can do this in the US. Now, the world of Fairy Tail is one in which people who practice magic, known as wizards, group up together and form guilds in order to go take on missions, gain work, you know, have some camaraderie, things like that. So it's pretty much just like any guild that you would see in any kind of fantasy show or fantasy video game. They group up in order to use their powers to help get stronger, to help do different quests, and just to have a place to hang out and use their magic abilities. And the game focuses on the Fairy Tail Guild, which is a really strong, but a really wild and rowdy bunch of magicians that use their powers to, like I said, go and complete quests, and a lot of times cause damage or cause problems unintentionally. And the game picks up kind of in the middle of the Fairy Tail story, starting off with the Tenra arc, and goes all the way through the Grand Magic Games, the Tartaros, and the Avatar arcs of the show. And as for the battle system, it uses all of the things that you would kind of be looking for in a classic JRPG, such as turn-based battling, flashy special attacks, combo attacks, super forms, etc. All these are going to be there in the fighting, and you can check it out and see for yourself if it's something that you would like. If you like classic turn-based fighting, something that you probably would definitely like. Now, their own unique spin on the battle system is that they use a 3x3 grid in which you're going to be fighting. And so your characters and the enemy characters will be strategically positioned in different places. All of your abilities are going to have different hit windows, whether it be completely in a straight line, hitting one square, hitting on a diagonal, hitting at various different points, all those kinds of things. And this forces players to strategize and figure out what is going to be the most effective attacks and magic to use in order to deal the most damage or deal with the most enemies. And the graphics look like, you know, standard fare for a JRPG game that's based on an anime show. So think of like the One Piece Pirate Warriors series. So it'll be similar to One Piece Pirate Warriors 4 that came out last year. And that's kind of what you would expect. Not the best graphics, maybe a little bit outdated looking, but still pretty good. So if you're an RPG fan or a Fairy Tail fan, why not go ahead and check this out? It's available now on the PS4, on the Switch, and on Steam. And so those are my recommendations for the weekend. As always, drop some comments. Let me know if there's anything next week that you want me to talk about. Let me know what your thoughts are on the Fairy Tail video game. What have you seen out of the NBA that you like or that you don't like? Are you checking out Transformers War for Cybertron? Anything like that. Now, I've been Pat That Varsity Geek. Peace out. Have a great weekend.